now, children, I will tell you the story from the Bible of Laban and Jacob, and then we will discuss it together. All right? Good. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and the beautiful Rachel. And Jacob loved the younger Rachel, so he asked Laban for her hand. Laban agreed if Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
He was an employer. Now, after Jacob worked for Laban for 7 years, do you know what Laban did? He fooled Jacob and gave him his ugly daughter Leah instead. So in order to earn Rachel back, Jacob had to work for another 7 years. You see, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust an employer. Do you understand? Good. Now, I will tell you the story of the sisters.
Is Papa up yet?
No, Mom.
Then enough lessons. We have Papa's work to do today. He came and stumbled home last night and fell into bed like a dead man. I couldn't get a word out of him.
Never let a man drink.
We have enough work to do. Let's go.
That was a very interesting lesson, Virgil.
Do you think so?
Although, I don't know if the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
And neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
My little sisters talk too much.
And what do you know of him, aside that he is the rabbi's son? Would you be so interested in him if you were, say, the shoemaker's son? Or the tinsmith's son?
At least I know this. He doesn't have any strange ideas about turning the world upside down.
Certainly, any new idea would be strange to you. Remember, the Lord said, "Let there be light."
Yes, but he wasn't talking to you personally.
You have spirit, maybe even a little intelligence, perhaps.
Thank you.
But what good is your brain? Without curiosity, it is a rusty tool. Good day.
We have an old custom here. A boy talks respectfully to a girl. But of course, that's too traditional for an advanced thinker like yourself.
Our traditions. Nothing must change. Everything is perfect the exact way it is.
We like our ways.
Our ways? Our ways are changing all over, but here. Here, men and women must be kept apart. Men work, women in the kitchen. Boys and girls cannot touch, should not even look at each other.
I am looking at you.
You're very brave.
Yeah.
Do you know that in the city, boys and girls can be affectionate without the permission of a matchmaker? Why, they even hold hands together. They even dance together. New dances, like this. I learned it here. Do you like it?
Yes, it's very nice.
What did you say? Do you have any news?
Ancient woman has the good book says good news will stay and bad news will refuse to leave. And there's another saying that goes.
Oh, you can die from such a man.
Ah, Zytel, my man. Come, Zytel. You are to be congratulated. You are getting married.
Married? What do you mean, Papa?
Blaise Wolf has asked for your hand.
Oh, I knew it! The butcher.
Oh, the Lord told me this would be our lucky day. Oh, I thank thee!
Well, what do you say, Zytel?
What can she say? My firstborn, a bride. May you grow old with him in fortune and honor.
Not like Professor, his first wife. She was a bit of woman. May she rest in peace. But not like my Zytel. And now, I must go thank Kienta. Oh, dear Lord, I thank thee!
Mazel tov, Zytel.
You call that a mazel tov? And you, Perching, aren't you going to congratulate my daughter?
Congratulations, Zytel, for getting a rich man.
Ah, again with the rich. What's wrong with being rich?
It's no reason to marry. Money is the world's curse.
Oh, and may the Lord smite me with it. May I never recover. Zytel knows I need her welfare. Am I right, Zytel?
Yes, Papa.
You see?
I see. I see very well.
Ah. So, well, Zytel, why are you so silent? Aren't you happy with this blessing? What? Tell me.
I can't marry him. I can't.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, you will.
If it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll dig ditches. Off. Oh, just don't make me marry him, Papa.
What's wrong with Blazer? He likes you.
I'll be unhappy with him all my days, Papa. Please don't make me marry him.
But we made an agreement. Us, an agreement is an agreement.
Is that more important than me, Papa? Please don't make me marry him. I'll be unhappy all my days.
All right. I won't force you.
Thank you, Papa.
It seems that it was not ordained that you should have all the comforts of life, or that we should have a little bit of joy in our old age after all our hard work.
Later, model, later.
Please, Artemia, I'd like to speak to you.
Not now, model. I have problems.
Artemia, I want to help you with those problems. I think I can help.
Oh, certainly. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, model.
At least listen to him, Papa.
All right. You have a tongue. Talk.
Reb Tevye, I understand you are having trouble finding a match for Zytel.
Oh, he also has ears.
I have a match for Zytel.
Really? What kind of match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit?
Like a glove.
Like a glove?
This match was made fit to measure.
Fit to measure, like a glove. Stop talking like a tailor and tell me who it is.
Please don't yell at me, Reb Tevye.
All right. Who is it?
Who is it?
Who is it?
Who is it? It's me! Myself.
Him? Himself?
Either you're completely out of your mind, or you're crazy.
He must be crazy. What are you, everything? The bridegroom, the matchmaker, the guests all rolled into one. I suppose you can perform the ceremony. You must be crazy.
Please don't yell at me, Reb Tevye. Now, as for arranging my own match, I know it's a little unusual.
Oh, unusual? It's crazy.
Times are changing, Reb Tevye. The fact of the matter is, your daughter and I gave each other a pledge more than a year ago that we would be wed.
You gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa. Gave each other a pledge.
They gave each other a pledge. They gave each other a pledge. Unheard of. Absurd. You gave other a pledge. Unthinkable. Where do you think you are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think they are? America? What do you think you're doing? You stitcher! You nothing! Solomon, this is always done, not here, not now. Some things I will not, I cannot allow. Marriages must be arranged by the Father. This should never be changed. One little time, you call it a prop, and where does it stop? Where does it stop? Do I still have something to say about my daughter? Or does anyone have to ask her father?
I've been meaning to ask you for some time, Reptilia, but I wanted to wait until I had saved up enough for my own sewing machine.
Stop talking nonsense! You're just a poor tailor.
That's true, Reptilia, but even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. I promise, Reptilia, your daughter will not starve.
He's beginning to talk like a man. On the other hand, what kind of match would that be with a poor tailor? On the other hand, he is an honest, hard worker. On the other hand, he is absolutely nothing. On the other hand, things are going to get worse for him. They can only get better. They gave each other a pledge, unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge, unthinkable. But in my daughter's face, she loves him, she wants him. Look at my daughter's eyes. Tradition. Yeah. Well, children, when can we arrange the marriage?
Oh, thank you, Papa.
Grab ticket. I won't be sorry.
I'm sorry already.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. They pledge together to mom and his children. Oh, Golda! Oh, what am I going to do about Golda? Oh, what am I going to do about Golda? Help?
You're a wonderful model.
It was a miracle! It was a miracle!
Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a Daniel once again, stood by his side, and miracle of miracles, walked him